Guts sounds familiar.
Yeah, it's ringing. It's like
the Guts sound. Guts sounds very familiar, but I'm sadly I'm my memory's failing me here. Once I see the character, though, it'll make much more sense.
Just thinking the character from Berserk. That's it.
Oh, I know. Yeah, I'm just like, I swear, or I'm thinking Gatsu for Melee, something. But Guts sounds so familiar. Makes my head hurt. Greninja. Okay, I can't say that I know who this is, but Greninja Falco, a very interesting matchup to see.
Yeah, so something we're going to have to see a lot of is, like, is Nexus going to be able to handle the pressure? You said he was very rushdown.
Yeah.
That's actually just all Greninja's game plan, right? All rushdown, all setups. Right there already, the down tilt dash attack, or down tilt or dash attack into the up smash, and that's all the setup he wants.
But Nexus finding a little bit of a setup on his own with the down air. Great chasing with the drag down air, but Guts jabbing out of it.
Yeah, gets the up tilt as the anti-air, tries to follow it up. Again, Guts is just not letting Nexus land and just calming it out with the anti-airs constantly. But nice grab, gets him up in the air, doesn't follow up with the back air. Resets the neutral, gets the forward air into the up tilt.
Not finding the back air off that up tilt, but now you have Guts in the corner here. And finding a reversal back air, sending him into the corner. Very clever shield on the illusion. Drag down up air? No, just regular up there.
Yeah, that is a mix-up. Like, you have to be wary of what options the Greninja is doing. If he's dragging you down, you have to be ready to tech. If he's just doing the full up air for the damage, you got to be ready for that as well. So it's a little bit hard. It's a little bit difficult to play to figure it out in the moment, but it is something you have to watch out for.
This is the percent that Falco is going to struggle to find those combo kills, but we'll have a back air and an up throw that can eventually kill if you don't DI the lasers. And you see here, Guts is, he's utilizing his superior range with forward air and kind of trying to, like, shark under where he's landing and get some anti-airs into combos, but that was a very good neutral B catch. Oh, I like that attempt there. That should be death. Oh, air dodging through, drag down forward air, not fully connecting. Countering on the platform, no punish from Nexus.
Yeah, something I like to see from Guts is that the fact that he adapted his game plan so quickly.
Yep.
Right? Like, he was kind of getting comboed, but gets the call out with the back air on the illusion. But he's going back to his game plan that he adjusted it immediately. He saw how Nexus was playing at first and adjusted his game plan accordingly, you know? He was getting hit. I was like, okay, let me start zoning him out a little bit more. I'm at that range where he can't combo me. He needs to get that straight hit off of me. Let me just use my superior range and go from there.
And he's doing it so well here, catching Nexus and landing, forward tilting him to the corner. Wake up, down tilt's gonna be able to take it. It's a move that a lot of people don't remember. You think of more traditional kill options like a back air, but down tilt being a very devastating one at that. Ooh. Up there. I like that.
That up air was actually so smart because we saw Nexus was posturing for that drop zone down air. Had he gone for it, he actually might have gotten the kill on him. So using that up air was super smart to say, get off this ledge. This ledge is mine, and it protected himself as well.
And Nexus is making these correct guesses on where Guts wants to land with these grabs. And it's being, you know, it's causing a lot of percent buildup, and any of these up throws can convert into a kill. Now I think the percent might be close for Nexus, but down tilt not going to be able to take it.
Alright, reset back to neutral, going back to the straight hit, finishes it with the up smash, but Guts gets the tech read on the platform with the up smash and gets the next stock.
Beautiful empty line and very good DI on the throw, but kind of a frame trap there. You air dodge trying to avoid the lasers, you get hit with a forward air instead, and now we see a 41% on that opening. Insane.
Yep, that's the setup I was talking about earlier. Greninja's on all those combos. You gotta be ready for those every single time. Down tilt or dash tag into up smash is just a huge amount of percent.
Unfortunate misplay on the ledge there, but able to make it back unscathed. Guts now going for the center of the stage. They're getting punished with a forward air from Nexus. Nexus on the ledge trap is going to be dangerous, but Guts making his way back to center.
Oof! Let's try to call him out that forward smash if he was just a little bit closer, but Nexus using the fade back correctly there and getting away from it just in time.
They're DIing their options very well here. They're not getting, like, so much off the opening.
Oh, he caught up the air dodge!
Oh, wow. Finding the down tilt read at air dodge in place is going to get you killed there with a forward smash. That was insane.
Yeah, that was an insane read.
Yeah.
I think that was something he read earlier in the middle of the match. Mm-hmm. He saw him trying to read the air dodge options before, and he said, okay, he's going to air dodge. I'm going to call it out. He's maybe air dodge away, air dodge in. Either way, the only thing that escapes me from that point is probably air dodge away. Mm-hmm. So I'm good to cover either air dodge, neutral air dodge, and towards me because of the charge forward smash.
Exactly.
And he saw the neutral, and he just finishes it off.
Yeah. What I've been noticing is, I kind of pointed out a little bit earlier, but their DI is very good on their combo. They seem to have a basic understanding of what these characters want, which I think is important, especially against combo-heavy characters like these two. Town and City, I know Nexus likes the stage. He wants a little bit of more range here. Maybe he's going to play a little bit more defensively, maybe utilize that illusion as a burst option, but finding a nair into some percent here.
Yeah, so probably he's a little bit more comfortable as well. Longer stage lets him run around a bit more, play around with the space. And it's also, in addition to that, the side platforms are side blast zones are a lot closer.
Mm-hmm.
So if he gets like an up tilt back air near like kind of the middle to the edge of the stage, like it might kill a lot sooner than Guts is ready for.
Oh, catching the air dodge with a nair there, but no follow up. Another side B back to the center of the stage, not kind of remaining unpunished here. Not air dodging through, just getting caught with an up air.
Going for the damage, tries to call it out with the down tilt. Nice dash back on the illusion, gets the punish, but no follow up.
Missing the timing on that illusion once again, not being able to take it. Okay, I like that shine on the neutral B, it keeps him honest there.
Oh, the down tilt up smash not going off there, but gets the up tilt back air, not going to get the stock there from Nexus. I mean, forgot that, I mean, sorry.
Very good DI there. Playing out with the platform there a little bit, utilizing that neutral B, trying to find some way to get back out. No air dodge that time, avoiding the frame trap.
And something I've noticed Nexus has been doing is using a shine, but F-Tilt just killed. Not ready for that. The eye was just not ready.
Speaking of kills, though, that was a very clever pickup from Nexus. He's taking the stock with an up air there and back to an even game, but a very smart anti-air. I really like that dash back into it. Was that a down tilt to get a little bit more percent there?
Yeah, so I see a little bit of intricacies with Nexus' playstyle, right? Like, he's using illusion a lot more than I would be ready for from a Falco, right? Using it as kind of like a space creator. Like, I'm getting, like, this is my space, in addition to that, I'm also moving it and taking control of center stage.
Yeah, it's very fast, and he's able to kind of punish you for jumping. Like, he'll just take center stage away from you with that illusion because you're trying to jump. But wow, what a forward smash. Maybe a misinput, but finding the Guts just kind of mashing in the corner there and not getting his shield out in time.
And that's actually where the side blast zones from Town and City come in play right there.
Yep, exactly.
It was it's a lot closer than the other stages that we have. That probably only kills on this stage.
Mm-hmm.
So really, that stage pick really coming in clutch here for Nexus.
Yeah, another side B attempt. Guts getting caught, not shielding center of the stage. But a forward air sending him into the corner. Now Nexus on the recovery.
Nice. I like that adaptation, right, from Guts. He notices that Nexus has been going in on it, but the substitute's going to take him out.
Yep.
But I want to finish this slot because this is actually really important for that adaptation that he made. That Guts is, he's been noticing the illusion when it's hit on shield, it stops in front. And he tries to punish it with a down tilt on shield every time. Mm-hmm. But Nexus gets his shield out just in time. But that last interaction got the grab instead.
Yep.
And adjusts it for the punish appropriately.
37% off an open up for Guts here. But that side B is going to punish him. Wow. Side B up air, back air.
Not going to
take it. Yeah, on especially save like Town and City. But now he has a ledge trap here. Interesting recovery mix up. Back air not being the strong hit. Getting hit with a laser there maybe out of his substitute. I like that drift from Nexus, keeping his forward air safe on shield. He just needs a back air here, finding the up smash, gonna be able to take it to a game three situation.
Yeah, both these players doing a really good job of reacting to how each other are playing, right? You know, we saw Guts earlier, as I pointed out, with the grab onto the illusion there, and Nexus himself, you know, calling out a lot more of Guts' options and making him feel like he has to do something rather than just sit and shield. And I think that's making Guts a little bit antsy.
First game three of the night, second game. Usually we see a lot of 2-0s early on, but game three means a lot more adaptation from both players, so I'm excited to see it. You were talking about some of the punish adaptations you were seeing on shield. I'm seeing Nexus utilizing that side B a little bit more, even on a bigger stage to take some space, so it's going to all come together on this game number three here, Falco versus Greninja.
We're going back to Town and City, so I think it was fine. I don't think there was anything really particularly wrong with how either of these players were playing the stage out. I just think that maybe Guts was thinking, oh, maybe if that fourth smash just didn't kill me, or I was a little bit more patient on that, then maybe it would have gone my way. So I can see him coming back here. I think it's an all right choice.
I agree, and now you see both of them kind of taking turns comboing each other, but both of them able to get out of them without taking too much early percent there, and just continuing to trade back and forth with disadvantage and advantage states.
Yeah, and so we've seen Guts for three games now, and we've kind of noticed that he's been very committed to not doing a lot of the drag down combo. He just wants that damage.
Yep.
Like, he's not doing a lot of the drag down mixes that we're used to from Greninja. He's just like, I want the damage. I want to keep you in disadvantage state, and then I'll go from there.
Yeah, exactly. I like that. That's a great way of saying how Guts is playing this out. And Nexus, he's going for these, but he's not getting them. So now I think he's opting for just the straight up percent here.
Yeah.
Oh,
these
good
guys
on the laser.
These guys are also a lot shielding a lot more. Shielding a lot more neutral, giving each other the respect that they deserve, right? They're like, okay, we've been kind of swinging at each other. Let's be more careful about how I'm approaching it. But as we saw right there, Guts holding his shield appropriately, but caught him out of the shadow sneak.
Yeah. That was a very good forward air from Nexus. He was kind of threatening that space, and Guts not respecting his aerials there and getting caught with one. But now a drag down combo here, up throw, back air or up air instead?
Yeah, Nex is pulling out of like, you know, you're not beating the, ooh, the DI. Ooh,
Hungry Box, yeah, he's not in the venue yet, but the DI is. That was not very good DI on that back air at all.
That's the same kind of situation we saw from Guts in the second game as well, kind of dying early because on the side of the blast zone because he just wasn't ready for an option.
Oh no, that substitute attempt getting punished very dearly by Nexus. He's just all over Guts here, not giving him any room to breathe. Oh, what a downer from the platform.
Oh, he was trying to read it, but gets the forward air to seal out that stock. 2-1. Guts is going to have a mountain to climb here if he wants to take this game.
Oh, I like that drag down. Forward air into the back air is going to be able to take it. And Nexus with a JV3 game 3 there. He looked very comfortable on that stage.
Yeah, definitely. The side platforms being a lot closer really helped out his game plan here.